In today's session, I will continue into the analytics. So analytics also, we have seen a lot of analytics yesterday related to inventory management. We'll continue the reviewing the analytics today also. I will start with the inventory management. Also, there is a further some analytics available. We'll be starting it from there, and then we'll jump into the procurement analytics. So that is the agenda for today's session. So if you guys have any questions, queries, you can ask it now. Do we have any questions, queries? Okay, we don't have any questions or queries. So I would be proceeding ahead. So let me jump into the system and then we'll see the analytics. First, we'll see the analytics for the inventory side, inventory management analytics. So let's switch to the analytical applications. So we'll also go through these analytical application, which is specific for procurement. So we were doing this inventory analytics, right? So I still need to go through these ones. We'll be going through these ones. What we have covered is the basic applications, all the stock related applications we have covered. These applications also we have covered. So basically what I have done in our last session, if you remember, I have gone into the stock multiple materials. And from there, I jumped into the multiple different applications. So I'm not going through the single application, but all of these application or most of this application going to the managed stocks, to the single material, to the plant transfer, to the slow moving, non-moving. I jumped from the same single application. I have jumped into the multiple places. Okay, so the managed stock also we have seen. So let's see some another application which is available. So we have a material inventory value balance summary. So it will take a little bit of time to load because I'm using it first time on this system after the remote desktop has been refreshed. So because it is loading first time, it will take some time. But if I will be using the same application second time or third time, it would work very faster. So ledger company code, let me define SGPA. Reporting date is fine. I'm going into the data analysis. Now it is showing me for the particular company code, for the particular ledger with the GL account. And it's also showing me the product group which has been created. What is the inventory quantity? And what is the amount in currency? Okay, so that is it's showing me. It is showing me the amount in company code currency, global currency, and free defined currency. As you see that with the material ledger, we can see it in three different currency. So that kind of details you can see it from here. Okay, so these kind of analysis, there are the multiple different kind of analysis has been available. We will also go through today to the query browsers also. Okay, so this is standard view. So I've gone into the navigation panel. So once I go into the navigation panel, so now what is this screen? This screen earlier, the first delivery they have given with the query browser, where they have given a lot of CDS views, which we can use as a dimensions and the variables, and user would be able to play around with the data. He would be able to flexibly analyze the data, and he would be able to generate his own reports by using a multiple parameters. That is what, by using a multiple different parameters, quickly he can enter the fields, remove the fields, and quickly he can jumble, drill down, all these kind of functionalities he can do. That is through the query browsers. Okay, then further going on, SAP has introduced these specific application as a separate applications. Although we'll go through the query browser, there also you will see we can save the query browsers also as your own applications. Now these kind of flexible analysis was earlier available. People was using through Tableau, people was using through BI, people was using through Lumira. So those kind of analytical tools, the BI, BW tools was having these functionalities where basically the drill downs and the play around with the dimensions and variables has been given. If you have worked on the Lumira also work in the same way. most of the Lumera reports works in the same way. When you create the dashboard for the users, to create a dashboard, you have a similar kind of screen in front of you where you need to select the dimensions and the measures, and based on that, your reporting set to be generated. So right now here, what you see, these are my rows. I have a company code, ledger, GL account, product group, profit center, and segment. So these are the my rows which is available, and these are my measures. What are my measures? We can check it from here. Inventory quantity is my measure. Amount in company code currency is my measure. Global currency is my measure. And then we can also, if they have defined in the further in total, I think now they can define 9 currency in, from the FI side. So if they have defined the further currency, that also you can try to check from here. So these are the measures available. Now, if you are working on the lower version, that also you will see the difference. In the higher version from 2019 and 2020, you can change the measures from here itself. Previous version, we were not able to select the measure from here. We need to go into the filters, and from filters, we need to select the measure. That was a drawback, which we have highlighted to the SAP in 2016 itself, and they have fixed it somewhere around 2019. Then I can also include, so this information is good, but I also want to include materials. So you can click it here, whether you can add it as a row or you can add it as a column as also. But these kind of analysis would be good if you add it as a row. So you want to further drill down. So now here the materials would also be added. So let me minimize this one so that we have a better view. Okay, it's not maximized. Yeah, let me maximize it. So if you see now here, your material codes are also available. Okay, what material codes we are having and what are the different inventory quantity it's having and what is the value it is having. Now, if you want to do the comparison, you can also go from here. One thing you can do is that you can export it as a PDF. Okay, you can also export